Go to the render setup to adjust animation settings in Corona. Make sure you have Corona render setup. Now, I will use the active time segment option. It is exactly the number of frames through which I have my camera animated. Let me show you. Okay, so it takes 45 frames. Now I will go back to the first frame. Next, make sure you have the correct output size setup. Then, we need to choose the location where our frames will be saved. Check the Save File option and choose the location. I always create a separate folder for each shot. We can call it shot_01, for instance. You can name it whatever you like. I always choose the AXR format as it saves more information than JPEG, for example. 16 bits channel. Okay, next, go to the scene and you should set one of the limitations here. Otherwise, the image will render until you stop it. And you definitely don't want to stop every frame manually in animations. So you can either choose pass limit, noise level limit, or time limit. This time, I will set up a noise level limit. Typically, I use 5%, but this is not a rule. It's always best to test one of the frames first to know the best value. Sometimes you'll need less noise, other times higher value will be good enough. Now, denoising. I always use Corona high quality. Similar situation with the amount value. I will use 0.5, but it's always better to test it first, as it will vary depending on the scene. Remember that it is not good to use too much denoising, as you will lose too many details. Okay, next, go to the Performance tab, as we need to set up the global illumination. By default, it is path tracing for both primary and secondary silver. But for animations, as the time is crucial here, we'll use UHD cache as a secondary solver because it typically speeds up rendering. Talking about render time, RenderFarm is the sponsor of this video. They are the RenderFarm we use when we need to render quickly and don't have time to use our computers. They are perfect for RVS artists because they support all the popular software, but most importantly, they have all the plugins we need, so there won't be any unpleasant surprises. They've created a software plugin so everything can be set up in your application. 3ds Max, in my case. It checks the scene and automatically uploads it to the farm. After rendering is done, it downloads everything to your local folder. There are no hidden costs. You know how much you will pay for every render if you use their cost estimation tool. They're also great people. They're always there for us if we need something. They have 24/7 human support, and the best part is that this time, you can get 10% free render points on top of one purchase at RenderFarm when you use the code AVA10. Please note that it is limited to one purchase per person. I will put the link to their website in the corner and in the description below, so you can check them out and get your bonus render points. Okay, let's go back to the GI settings. And now, we need to adjust the UHD cache settings. We need to change the preset to animation, flicker free. Okay, now I will show you two methods depending on the scenario we have. Up to this moment, everything stays the same for both cases. First scenario is the safest option when we have an animation with moving lights or objects. In this method, we use settings as they are by default. So we use calculate from scratch for precomputation and discard for after render. Now, when using this mode, the cache will be always calculated independently for each frame. By the way, we can of course add render elements in both scenarios if we want to. Anyway, we can hit the render button. Okay, let's focus on a few important things. After the preparing geometry stage is finished and computing GI starts, we can notice that the UHD cache precomputation begins to count up. The stage took 9 seconds in this case. What does it mean for us? For this animation, we'll spend almost 7 minutes just for the pre-computation stage. It may not sound a lot to you, but imagine that 45 frames of this scene are just a part of a whole animation. And after that, the renderer is starting to the actual rendering of the image. Why is it important? Because we can save up a lot of time if we only can reduce the time of pre-computation. Good news, it's possible. And this is the second method. By the way, during the rendering process, all the files will be saved in the selected previously folder. Now, the time for the second method that we typically use with a camera fly-through without any moving objects or lights. This method is divided into two stages. Firstly, we want to calculate UHD cache just for the first frame and use the same file later for other frames as well. To do so, we need to change after render to save to file. And then choose the correct location for the file. Now we can use the trick and change the time limit to 1 second, so the image will render only for this short period of time, and hit the render button. Okay, so the UHD cache is calculated now. Okay, 1 second of rendering, and we're going to the next frame. We can cancel rendering as the file we wanted is already saved. Let me show you. Here it is. We can delete this file as we need to render it from scratch. And now we're going to the second stage. Let's go back to the previous setting, so let's set the noise level limit to 5%. Next, in the Performance tab, change Precomputation to Load from File. We don't have to change the path, as it is the path to the file we saved previously. And click the render button now. You can notice that after preparing the scene, we have the rendering stage straight away. The UHD cache per computation is 0 seconds. Please note that you can try using the second method with moving objects or lights, as in some cases, it may perform well. The first method is safer though. Now we need to wait for all the files to be rendered and ready to combine into one video. To learn more about animations, download our free ebook. Also, watch my other videos on this topic. Here are my suggestions. Bye-bye!